Most noble, most highly honored sir. That is what he said. That is what Johann Sebastian Bach said. Most noble, most highly honored sir, for the quite exceptional and most gracious confidence of your noble self and all your collegium, I am most deeply obliged. And as it has always been my greatest pleasure to offer to your honor my most obedient service, I shall now be all the more zealous in waiting upon your honor at the appointed time and then to give satisfaction so far as in me lies. I beg you, accordingly, without giving yourself too much trouble, to communicate this my decision to the honorable collegium, and at the same time to convey to them my most obedient regards and to assure them of my sense of respectful obligation for their special confidence. Since, moreover, your honor has been good enough to take great pains in my behalf, not only in the present instance but heretofore as well, I acknowledge this with obedient thanks and assure you that it shall ever be my greatest pleasure to call myself your honors and my most especially highly honored sir's most obedient servant, Johann Sebastian Bach. Eisenach, raised in Lüneburg, and lived in Leipzig. And this is what he said. This is what Jack Bach said. This post was described to me in such favorable terms that finally I cast my lot in the name of the Lord and made the journey to Leipzig, took my examination, and then made the change of position. But since, one, I find that the post is by no means so lucrative as it had been described to me, two, I have failed to obtain many of the fees pertaining to the office, three, the place is very expensive, and four, the authorities are odd and little interested in music, so that I must live amid almost continual vexation, envy, and persecution. Accordingly, I shall be forced, with God's help, to seek my fortune elsewhere. My present post amounts to about 700 thaler, and when there are rather more funerals than usual, the fees rise in proportion. But when a healthy wind blows, they fall accordingly. As, for example, last year, when I lost fees that would ordinarily come in from funerals to an amount of more than 100 thaler. In Thuringia, I could get along better on 400 thaler than here with twice that many because of the excessively high cost of living. When standing erect, he was 2 feet wide. And this is what he said. He said, "Most noble and most esteemed cousin, that you and your dear wife are still well, I am assured by the agreeable note I received from you yesterday, accompanying the excellent little cask of wine you sent me, for which I send you herewith the thanks I owe you. It is, however, greatly to be regretted that the little cask was damaged, either by being shaken up in the wagon or in some other way. For when it was opened for the usual customs inspection here, it was almost two-thirds empty, and according to the inspector's report, contained no more than 6 quarts. And it is a pity that even the least drop of this noble gift of God should be spilled. Although my honored cousin kindly offers to oblige with more of the liqueur, I must decline his offer on account of the excessive expenses here. For, since the carriage charges cost 16 groschen, the delivery man 2 groschen, the customs inspector 2 groschen, the inland duty 5 groschen 3 pfennig, and the general duty free groschen, my honored cousin can judge for himself that each quart costs me almost 5 groschen, which for a present is really too expensive. Bach was an ornery man. Johnny Bach was an ornery and a cantankerous man. But when he spoke of music, this is what he said. He said, I am not a little surprised that the university dares to refer to an ample honorarium of 13 taler 10 groschen that I am said to have received from them, and to contradict me by denying that I have done the work for nothing until now, seeing that the honorarium is something separate and apart from the salary of 10 florin, and a gratuity does not exclude the salary. Actually, however, my complaint is not in respect to the honorarium, but concerns the salary, which has hitherto been denied me in the amount of 12 florin. Indeed, as may be seen from the very rector's accounts cited by the university, even this honorarium, which is supposed to have amounted to 13 taler 10 groschen, has not been paid to me in full, but instead I have been paid not more than 16 groschen 10 pfennig every quarter, instead of the 20 groschen 6 pfennig stated in the rector's accounts. And at the 3 high feast days, as well as at the Feast of the Reformation, each time not more than 1 thaler instead of 2 thaler 12 groschen, making a total of only 6 thaler 18 groschen instead of 13 thaler 12 groschen annually. Johann Sebastian Bach, umpteenth musician of the Bach family, is everlasting in the memory of music lovers. For, surrounded by adversaries, this is what he said. He said, la da da dee dee.